Let's pull down a horizontal ruler. It doesn't necessarily have to be right in the middle because we'll be moving it anyway. Now right click, new shape layer. Let's open that up and we're gonna create a path. That will enable your pen tool. Draw a path from left to right. Just snap this down to your guide. And also add in a stroke. For now, I'm gonna increase this. That way we can see a little bit better, maybe 10 pixels. But I do wanna add some color to it. Let's add in a zigzag. Open up the zigzag settings, increase our size. Okay, so let's add in a repeater. Let's open up our repeater settings. We're gonna change our number of copies, we'll say to 10. Make sure your position is 0, 0, and then increase our Y position. Adjust our stroke size settings. Maybe we'll bring this down to say 5. So it's a little bit thinner. We can pull up the Y value of this repeater position a little bit. You have this start and end opacity. So now if we bring our end opacity down to 0, we can see how we start to get a little bit of a gradient. You can go in the opposite direction if you want the gradient to come in that way. So just kind of a cool little effect. Press P to bring up our position and let's move this to the very top of our comp. Now all we have to do is repeat this repeater. So let's add in another repeater. We'll make the number of copies, we'll say 10. So the way that the repeaters interact with the contents of your shape layer depend on how they're stacked. So this repeater here is affecting everything above it, and this repeater is affecting everything above it as well. So the values that you change in repeater 2 are gonna really depend on what you have in repeater 1. This repeater is just gonna make copies basically of what we've already created. So if we move our Y position down, we can see that they're starting to stack. If we make our X position 0, now we can see the effect that we're having, like that. So now we go back into repeater 1 and we can increase the number of copies. Maybe we'll make 20. This repeater here is affecting the path, zigzag, and stroke. This repeater here is affecting our repeater 1. So depending on whatever we do here, it's going to affect this repeater. Maybe for zigzag, we can change the number of ridges. Maybe we'll make 5. We can make 20. You can make this a little bit smaller size, and they all are going to be uniform and update automatically. Take repeater 2's Y position. Move that down a little bit further. So just experiment with this and kind of see what you can come up with. And of course, you can always change the color of this to get whatever effect you want. So this is just like a really quick, cool way to create a background by repeating the repeater and using ZigZag.